If he's worthy to be praised, if he's worthy to be adored, if he's worthy to be exalted, I need you to open up your mouth and say, God, you're worthy to be praised. God, you're worthy to be adored. All honor and glory belongs to you, Jesus. Because if it had not been for the Lord who was on my side, I don't know where, I don't know where, I don't know where, I don't know where I would be. So I owe him glory. So I owe him honor. So I owe him thanks. I gotta give him glory. I gotta give him thanks. Because he's Jesus. Because he's Jesus. Because he's Jesus. Because he's Jesus. Come on, clap your hands and open up your mouth. Because he's Jesus.
Everyone standing, hallelujah, everyone's praises. The hour of holy orders and affairs are upon us. Therefore, we are to make a joyful noise unto the Lord, all ye lands. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing.
Yes, Lord.
Know ye that the Lord, he is God. It is he that hath made us, and not we ourselves.
Yes.
We are his people and the sheep of his pasture.
Yes.
Enter into his gates with thanksgiving. Anybody thankful this morning?
Yeah.
Into his courts with praise. Anybody got praise on their lips? Be thankful unto him and bless his name. For the Lord, I say the Lord is good. His mercy is everlasting, and his truth endureth to all generations. And the people of God said, of the Lord. Amen. You may have your seat in this place. Amen. We are to now welcome our officiator, the Reverend Jonathan Assad McClammon.
All right. As it has already been said, the hour of elevation is here.
Yeah.
We've got that out of the way now. I need everybody that knows that God has been good to you. I need you to give God a shout.
Thank you.
Be seated. You need to act like you're Michael Methodist. Bring it in. God has a good day.
Reading your program along with Sue, our Reverend Jarnell. Frazier, after he has finished reading the word, according to your program, there is something he will say after, you will then respond. Then there will be a lesson from the epistle, Hebrews 5, verses 1 through 10. Our lector, the Reverend Jamal P. Brantley, he will then, after finish reading, he will say the word of the Lord, and then you shall follow, and then we'll come back. Praise the Lord, in that order, in Jesus' name. As a matter of fact, then we will have the reading of the gospel. Give me that overseer. The reading of the gospel. Overseer, amen, will come with the reading of the gospel, and then we'll go from there in Jesus' name. Amen.
Let the church shout hallelujah. Amen. A reading from the Old Testament scripture, 1 Kings 1, verse 39 to 42. The Levite priest took the horn of the Lord out of the tabernacle and anointed Solomon. And they blew the trumpet, and all the people said, God save King Solomon. And all the people came out of the heaven, and the people piped with pipes, rejoiced with great joy. So that the earth went with the sound of them. And then all the guests that were with him heard it as they made an end of eating. And when Joab heard the sound of the trumpet, he said, wherefore is this noise of the city being in an uproar? And while he had spake, behold, Jonathan, the son of Abraham, the priest, came. And then God said unto him, come in, for thou art learned man. Bring us good tidings. This is the word of the Lord to his people.
Thanks be to God. Following your programs, church.
Amen. Lesson from the epistle, book of Hebrews, chapter 5, verses 1 through 10. For every high priest taken from among men is ordained for men in things pertaining to God, that he may offer both gifts and sacrifices for sins. Who can have compassion on the ignorant and on them that are out of the way? For that he himself also compassed with infirmity, and by reason hereof he ought as for the people, so also for himself to offer for sins. And no man taketh this honor unto himself, but he that is called of God, as was Aaron. So also Christ glorified not himself to be made in the high priest, but he that said unto him, thou art my son, today have I begotten thee. As he said also in another place, thou art a priest forever after the order of Melchizedek, who in the days of his flesh, when he had offered up prayers and supplications with strong crying and tearings unto him, that he was able to save him from death, and was heard of the fearing. Though he were a son, yet learned he obedience by the things which he suffered, and being made perfect, he became the author of eternal salvation unto all them that obeyed him, called of God and high priest after the order of Melchizedek. Here ends the epistle of the Lord Jesus Christ. The people,
let us stand.
We shall read the Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, St. John, the 10th chapter. We shall commence our reading at the 11th verse. I am the Good Shepherd. The good shepherd giveth his life for the sheep. But he that is a hireling and not the shepherd, whose own the sheep are not, seeth the wolf coming and leaveth the sheep and fleeth, and the wolf catches them and scattereth the sheep. The hireling flee, because he is a hireling and careth not for the sheep. I am the good shepherd. And I know my sheep, and am known of my own. As the Father knoweth me, even so I know the Father. And I lay down my life for the sheep. Finally, verse 16, and the other sheep I have, which are not of this fold, them also I must bring, and shall hear my voice, and there shall be one fold and one shepherd. For this is the gospel of our Lord, and the people shall say, praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. You may have your seats.
Will we join with the hymn of the church, Lift Him Up? Amen. I know we all know that. Praise the Lord.
Elizabeth City, North Carolina.
Amen. Thank God for our evangelist Stacy. with me. Let's see how you clap for Jesus.